let me use the word monism, which has been used in many ways, but in this particular case it's quite appropriate, the belief that there is just one thing that explains everything. In this case, it is the universal laws. While in biology we have a dualism, which means we have the genetic, we have the universal laws, and we have the genetic program. Now this is related to a way in which we make explanations in biology. If I, for instance, want to explain why a particular bird, let's say a flycatcher that nests here in the garden, migrates in the winter to South America, we can find that there are a series of causes for this that can be reconstructed, and that can be called proximate and ultimate or evolutionary causes. Proximate causes are all the physiological processes that go on immediately that have to do with the phenotype of the of this organism and permits it to do these things, and they are mostly related to physiology. And the other set of causes, and inanimate nature, there is only that one set of causes, which is the what is related to the universal laws. The second set of causes in an organism are the ultimate or evolutionary causes or explanations, and that is this organism migrates because it has a genetic program which tells it when the temperature drops below a certain point or the photoperiodicity reaches a certain level, then it is time for you to get moving and migrate to South America. And that again is a absolute, complete difference between organisms and inanimate matter. In inanimate matter, we have only one set of causations, and living organisms, we always have both proximate and ultimate, and a full explanation of any biological phenomenon requires the solution of both of these causations.